this series, we're talking about how to expand a sum through its first few terms. We've been given the series 1 over n squared. So this value right here is our series, and oftentimes we write our series as a sub n. So we could say the series is a sub n, and a sub n is equal to 1 divided by n squared. So that's our series, the function that defines our series. And this sigma notation here, this thing that looks like an e, tells us take the sum of this series. The value below the sigma notation is n equals 1. This tells us start at the term that corresponds with n equals 1. This tells us where to stop. So it tells us to stop at a value of n equals 6. So if we want to expand this series through its first 6 terms, we would take the values n equals 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, the first 6 terms, and add them together. Because we have this summation notation here, we're taking the sum, so we add all those terms together that we find. So if we're looking at the term that corresponds with n equals 1, n equals 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, those are the first 6 terms. That's where the index tells us to start and stop. And all we have to do is start with n equals 1, plug that into our series, 1 divided by n squared, and simplify that value. So first we'll say plug in n equals 1. Here we're going to get 1 divided by 1 squared. So let's just go ahead and write that out for now. So 1 divided by 1 squared. Then we're going to plug in n equals 2, and because we're taking the sum, because we have the summation notation, we want to add all these terms together. So plugging in n equals 2, we're going to get 1 over 2 squared. Plugging in n equals 3, we'll get 1 over 3 squared. Then we'll get 1 over 4 squared, 1 over 5 squared, and finally 1 over 6 squared. And we stop there because this value right here of 6 tells us stop when you get to n equals 6. In other words, your last term will be the term where you plug in n equals 6, which is the term that we just found here. So that's where we're going to stop. So now we just need to simplify. So here in the denominator we get 1 squared, which is just 1. 1 divided by 1 is 1, so here we get 1. Then we're going to get plus 2 squared is 4, so we get 1 fourth. 3 squared is 9, so we get 1 ninth. 4 squared is 16, so 1 over 16. And then we're going to get 1 over 25 and 1 over 36. And that's all there is to it. This value that we just found, this series, this sum, is the exact same thing as what we were originally given. This notation right here, it's just a different way of writing it. So this whole thing here is exactly equal to this whole thing here. This is just a simpler way of writing it. So if you were given this sum to start with and you wanted to write it in summation notation, you could write it this way. And we'll talk about how to do that a little bit later. But here we just started with summation notation. We were given the series and we were given the index, and we expanded this series, we expanded the summation notation into an expanded sum. And that's how you expand a series through its first few terms. Could you use some extra help with math? Click the button to head over to calculusexpert.com. It's where I've collected and organized all of my best resources, including exclusive videos, notes, quizzes, and even formula sheets. It's the perfect resource whether you're struggling, or if you want to take your learning further, or even if you just want to save yourself some time studying. So check it out, because I know it'll help.